Hello friends, welcome to BusyMail channel. My name is Munsha Khatun. In my previous video, I discussed about the cellular adaptations. Okay, and I discussed it about its definition and the types of cellular adaptation in brief. And I also discussed why in which type of cells hypertrophy is taking place and in which type of cells hyperplasia is taking place. Okay. So in non-dividing cells or the permanent cells, such for example neurons, okay, cardiac muscle, skeletal muscle, in them hypertrophy is taking place to adapt the increased workload, okay, that is increasing the size is taking place, whereas in the hepatocytes, in them hyperplasia is taking place, okay. And the dividing cells are divided into stable cells and labile cells. The stable cells are those cells which are dividing when they are needed. For example, in hepatocytes, if we see in partial hepatectomy, the hepatocytes started dividing, whereas the labile cells, they are continuously dividing. For example, the lining epithelium of the skin and GID, that is hyperplasia, is taking place in the dividing cells. Okay, now in this video I am going to discuss about the hypertrophy in detail. Okay, so please, if you like the video, then please share, like and comment and watch this video completely, and please subscribe the channel and press the bell icon so whenever I post the video you will get the update, and follow me on Instagram busy_med. So let's start with today's topic, that is about the hypertrophy. In my coming videos, I am discussing in detail about the hyperplasia, atrophy, metaplasia. Hypertrophy. In my previous video, I discussed hyper means increase and trophy means size. So, increase in size of the cells is taking place. That is increase in growth and thus resulting in the increase in the size of the cells. Okay. So hypertrophy is again, it is divided into physiological hypertrophy and pathological hypertrophy. Physiological hypertrophy is the one which is taking place in physiological conditions, that is in normal conditions, whereas the pathological hypertrophy is the one which is taking place in pathological, that is in abnormal conditions. So physiological hypertrophy and pathological hypertrophy. Okay, for example, physiological hypertrophy example is in skeletal muscle of bodybuilders. Okay, so we will be seeing physiological hypertrophy in the skeletal muscle of bodybuilders. So there will be increase in the size of the cells to adapt the increase in the workload. There will be increase in the workload, so to adapt that in the cells, there will be increase in the size. Okay, and the second example is pregnant uterus. This is the first example, and the second example is pregnant uterus. In pregnant uterus, both hypertrophy as well as in pregnant uterus, both hypertrophy as well as hyperplasia will take place. There will be increase in the size of cells and as well as there will be increase in the number of cells. Okay, whereas in pathological hypertrophy, what is happening, it is because of the abnormal conditions there will be increase in the cell size. Take for example left ventricular hypertrophy. Left ventricular hypertrophy is because of the due to the systemic hypertension, so there will be increase in afterload, and to the heart work against increasing afterload, and because of this reason there will be increase in the size of the ventricle, resulting in the left ventricular hypertrophy. So this is the example of the pathological hypertrophy. And now I am going to discuss about the mechanism of hypertrophy. Okay, mechanism of hypertrophy, how this hypertrophy is taking place in the cells. So whenever cell encounters any mechanical sensors or agonist growth factors, so whenever there will be presence, these are the triggers or the stimuli, so they stimulate these cells, and because of this reason there will be increase of transcription factors, which will be causing in the increasing the transcription, so that the DNA is convert to the RNA, or RNA is formed from the DNA. And when there will be increase in the RNA synthesis, so then there will be increase in the protein synthesis, because RNA then forms the proteins, so there will be increase in protein synthesis, and then there will be increase in the myofilaments, and thus result in the left ventricular hypertrophy or increase in the size of the cell. Okay, so there will be first what is happening because of the stimuli or because of the triggers, and there will be three triggers. Okay, it can be three triggers are there. It can be mechanical sensors. Okay, agonist growth factors. Mechanical sensors, for example, take integrin. Agonist, for example, take alpha adrenergic hormones. So they will be causing increase of transcription factors. There will be increase in the transcription factors, and this will be causing increase in the transcription, that is RNA synthesis will increase from DNA. So RNA is getting synthesized more. Okay, so increase in the RNA synthesis, and this will in turn increase the protein synthesis. RNA in turn forms the protein, so increase in protein synthesis, increase in myofilaments, and thus increase in the size of the cells, that is resulting in the hypertrophy. Increase in the protein synthesis, increase in the myofilaments, increase in the size of the cells, and thus resulting in the hypertrophy. Okay, so this is all about the hypertrophy. In this video I discussed about its definition, that is increase in the size, and its types, that is it is classified into physiological hypertrophy, pathological hypertrophy. Physiological hypertrophy, which is taking place in the physiological conditions, for example in the skeletal muscle of the bodybuilders because of the exercise. Okay, so because of the increased workload, because so the skeletal muscle will get size will get increased. Okay, and in the pregnant uterus, okay, in pregnant uterus both hypertrophy will take place, as well as hyperplasia will also take place in pregnant uterus. This is the most important point to remember. Whereas in pathological hypertrophy, the example is left ventricular hypertrophy, and this is because of the systemic hypertension, and this will result in the increase in the afterload. So there will be increase in the afterload. So because of this reason, to adapt this increase in the afterload, because of the systemic hypertension, there will be increase in the size of the ventricle, resulting in the left ventricular hypertrophy. Mechanism of hypertrophy. Hypertrophy is started mainly because of three triggers. Mechanical sensors, okay, for example integrin, agonist, for example alpha adrenergic hormones, and growth factors. So because of these, transcription factors will get increased, and RNA formation is taking place, increase in the RNA synthesis, increase in the protein synthesis, increase in the myofilaments, and thus result in the hypertrophy. trophy. In my next video, I will be discussing about the hyperplasia. So this is all about hypertrophy. So if you like the video, then please press on the like button and comment in the comment box. And please subscribe the channel. And please share this video with your friends so that they should also get benefit. Thank you.